All right, guys, a couple of little ways I know how you can do this trick. Get yourself the item you want to do and stick it on your paper. Set your camera and make sure that all the four edges of your paper are all visible. And take the picture. All right, so you want to open up Photoshop, go to New and select the sort of paper you've got. I've used A4, so I'm going with A4. If you've used US paper, select that. And drag your photo into your workspace. The next thing you want to do is line up each four corners of your paper onto the edges of your workspace. You can start off by dragging up the middle two pointers and get it as close as you can. You're going to have to zoom out a little bit just so you can reach it up there. Now get it as near enough as you can. And then when you've got it sort of close, you can go into the corners, hold down Control, and then you can warp your image. There's going to be a little bit of trial and error. You're going to have to sort of move the top and the bottom and the left and the right and just sort of keep moving them about a little bit until you get them sort of near enough. You're probably going to have to zoom out a little bit more. All right, that looks pretty good. So hit the little tick button and that will place it down and we're done. So all you got to do now is print it out. Alright, so all you got to do now is set the height of your camera right and we're done. If you want to use an existing image off of Google or something like that, then you can download this template file, link in the description, and drop your image into your workspace. The next thing you want to do is drag that down into the confines of the black grid. Doesn't matter if you cut a little bit off, if you don't mind losing the corners and stuff. As long as you've got the main image that you want to keep within the confines of the black lines. Once you've got that in there and you're happy, you then have to merge the image layer with the black grid. So go ahead and hit shift, click on the black grid, right mouse button and link layers. Alright, so now if you hit Control and T to transform, then as before, you can click on these little pointers and drag the image about. And the idea is that you match the black squares with the blue ones. So get it up to there, then Edit, Transform, Perspective, and then you can move these little corner blobs, sort of drag it out until you get the black lines parallel with the blue ones. You probably have to Control T to transform again just to get that last little bit spot on. Alright, that's looking pretty good. So hit the little tick button and turn off both the grids, black on the blue grid, leave just the image showing, and print it out, and you're good to go. All right, guys, give us a thumbs up, subscribe, and see you next time.